Damas y caballeros, público presente, familiares y amigos que se reúnen esta noche en su estudio y salón Besosan. Nos reunimos en esta noche mágica y hermosa para celebrar las 15 primaveras de Yasmín Fonte, a quien le vamos a dar un fortísimo aplauso. Y quien celebra sus 15 primaveras y su presentación en sociedad. Sin más preámbulos, esta noche mágica comienza así. Llevamos a Cris para hacer el cambio de las zapatillas. Un fuerte aplauso a Cris. Vamos a darle ánimo. Vamos, Cris, que tú puedes. Cris está más nervioso que bueno. Sí.
invitamos a todo el público presente a tomar asiento. E invitamos a Cris y a Yasmín al centro de la pista. Y Cris le entrega a Yasmín a su chamberlain Daniel para que vaya al centro de la pista. A quien le damos un fortísimo aplauso. Estamos en vivo, vamos de nuevo entonces. Vamos a darle un fuerte aplauso a Yasmín y a Daniel. Yasmín nace un 24 de julio del 2006. Su hobby es el baile y el canto. Y en un futuro desea ser una gran abogado. Para Yasmín y Daniel con este hermoso baile, su último baile de 15 años. La deja en su trono como cual princesa. Y ahora llamamos al señor Juan Carlos Fonte a buscar a su hermosa hija y llevarla al centro de la pista para hacer su primer baile en sociedad y su primer baile formal como una gran y hermosa dama. aplaudimos nuevamente. Orgulloso padre, el señor Juan Carlos Fonte. Llamamos al centro de la pista a su hermosa madre, también para que baile con Yasmín. Fuerte aplauso para la señora Isabel Fonte. Aplausos y abrazos y besos para mami. Llamamos a la pista a Chris, a su hermano. Aplauso para Chris. Llamamos a la pista a Tiffany para que baile también con Yasmín. Vamos, Tiffany. Baile aquí con tú. Vamos. Vista a Yanni. Yanni, vamos, Yanni. Aplauso para Yanni. Finalmente llamamos a Daniel nuevamente a su chamberlain. Aplausos para Yasmín en estos hermosos 15 años de su vida, donde empieza una nueva travesía para su vida y su profesión. Vamos a continuación, vamos a darle el micrófono a Yasmín para hacer entrega de 15 importantes reconocimientos de luz para esas 15 personas que significan algo muy valioso en su vida. ¿Estás lista, Yamil? Sí. Sonido, ok. Uno, dos. Sí, uno, dos. Quien tiene, ajá, podemos encender la velita. Hay una vela que va a tener Yasmín y las personas que vamos nombrando van pasando y van prendiendo la velita que va a tener Yasmín.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, Yasmín. Velita número uno.
Mi mamá.
Ajá. Aplausos para la señora Isabel. Vamos. Velita número dos.
Mi hermano.
Para Cris. Velita número 7. Velita número 7. Velita número 8.
Velita número 10.
Velita número 10. Aguárdeme. Velita número 11. Velita número 11.
Ado.
Ajá. Para Ado. Velita número 12. Emily. El número 12, Emily.
Kimberly.
Ah, Kimberly, I'm sorry. Velita número 13.
Daniel.
Velita número 13 para Daniel Chamberlain. Aplauso para Daniel. Velita número 14.
Rosalind.
Aplauso. Velita número 14. Y la última velita, la número 15, ¿para quién sería? ¿Yasmín?
Yo.
Para ti, muy bien, eso es, para ti. Qué bueno. Ok, Yasmín, ya que tienes las velitas, toda tu gente que escogiste en este momento, nos gustaría que dijeras algunas palabras para todas estas personas que están aquí, a quien amas, admiras y respetas, y a todos tus invitados. Y nos preparamos para el brindis.
Mi mamá, who was always there for me, never let me be crying by myself, who's always been there by my side.
You got makeup.
Hold it back. My mom, who never let me be sad, never let me be mad at someone. My mom has always... My mom has always been by my side. Never left me. She was there for me when I had my nightmares, when I was a little girl. She was there to pick me up on my worst days. She was there to wipe my tears. She has never left me alone, even when I ask her to. My mom is truly my best friend, even though a soulmate for me is gonna be a guy, but my soulmate is my mom. My mom, when I was younger, she would say to me, whenever I would cry for something, for a dead, relative, she would tell me, it's okay, they're out there looking for you, they're looking out there, they're, they're right up there looking after you, and they don't like to see you cry. and neither do I. After that day, I cried a few times, but she was always there to pick me up, and she never let me be down. She always found some way to pick me up on my worst days. She's truly the best mom I can ask for. Me and her have our issues, but she's truly my best friend. As she always tells me, I'm your number one best friend. Get that through your head. My mom, who never, ever let me be mad at someone for something so stupid. My mom is there to pick me up, always to wipe my tears, never lets me be this mad at someone how I am right now. And someone knows who I'm mad at. But she's right there by my side, as always. And she will always be by my side. Because she's my mom. My brother. My brother, who growing up would make fun of me. My brother was kind of my bully, but but growing up, he taught me how to be brave, to be strong. Funny thing is, I haven't seen him cry in like 3 years. When I'm hurt, he's there by my side to wipe my tears and my mom is. These two, well, one out of five, have been by my side since I was born. He was always by my side. In fact, my name, Jasmine Juliana, is from him because he had picked it for me. He named me. My brother named me. And I'm very glad and thankful and grateful to have him in my life, even though he could be a little pain in the ass. But I'm glad that he's on my house. If it wasn't for him, certain things wouldn't be here. Him, my brother, who, as my mom, never let me be quiet. He would always tell me to be myself. Speak up. Ever since from that day, I have spoken up. And I've been more myself since of him, because of him. Growing up, he was the one person who told me, be yourself. Don't anyone drag you down. My mom and my brother and my sisters have been my number one supporters. Never let me be down about something that was idiotic. They would tell me straight up what's going on, whether it hurt my feelings or not. They would tell me what's going on. If I didn't like it, that's not my problem. That's not their problem. Because they're being honest with me. He has made me laugh. He has made me mad. He has made me happy. He has made me laugh till I cried. Till I cannot breathe. But what's a brother for if he can't make me laugh? He's my best friend. He's my best friend since I was literally born. And will be the day, he will be my best friend till the day I die. My sister, Yanni. Even though she's not blood related to me, she is in fact my sister. And if anyone would tell me, who is that girl with the red hair? I would say she's my sister. Because my brother and her met in middle school. So I've had her in my life almost, what, 8 years? And from that day since I met her, I knew she was real. She was gonna be my sister from that day. And out of everyone my brother has had come into the house, I always see Yanni. I do have a sister, and I do love her, but she, this girl, the red hair, she's one of my best friends, never let me, she would always pick me up. She would always tell me the truth, no matter how much it hurt me. She'd be my side, she'd be my shoulder to cry on. Always. My sister Tiffany. Soon enough, you're gonna see a choreography that she made, which was very hard to learn in a little bit of time. She is my best friend. She's truly honest with me. She has never let me go outside and be stupid. She always tells me to wipe her tears and be strong. And for that, I love her. And she'll always be my sister. Bravo. My sister, Rhonda. My sister, Rhonda. From the beginning, I would always hear coming in and coming out of the house. But from that day, she was gonna be a sister to me. She has been there for me when I didn't want to be my mom, when I was mad at my mom. I would go to her place and I would just chill for a little bit. Her house is kind of a chill spot. So this day. I love how she tells me every day, you're looking beautiful, even when I feel ugly or down. And for that, I truly do love her. Melody. My best friend from first grade. She has truly never left my side. Even though me and her stopped talking, she was always there. She would see me cry and she would ask me, what's wrong? I'm here for you. She's truly my best friend. I've known her for almost 10 years. Recently, something had happened, and she was right there to pick me up. She was right there by my side, making sure my makeup wasn't ruined for my keepsake. And she always found, whenever there was a problem, she would find a solution to it. And I am forever grateful to have her in my life. And I love you. David. David, I met you in the sixth grade, but yet we've been best friends for 3 years. You recently was there for me when I was going through something where I couldn't tell certain people. You were there to help me through this problem, and so was Melody, but you helped me through the most. You're truly a good friend, and you're truly my best friend too. And I'm very grateful for you. I love you. Mi papá. Javi. Mi papá. Who I love and I care about most of all. If anything was to happen to him, I would cry. My heart would break. There are times where I don't want to look at him because he has hurt me. But whether or not, he's still my dad. And if I would get a call that he had passed away, I would cry. Because regardless, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. He's my dad. He'll always be my dad, and I will always love him, no matter how many times I say I hate him. Because he's my dad, and I'm glad he's my dad, because he has taught me so many lessons from life. I love you. Te amo.
Bravo!
Mi hermana, Heidi. Mi hermana, Heidi. Growing up, she would always do my hair, dress me up, make me look amazing as a five-year-old. She would do me impossible hairstyles. Growing up from elementary, I would get dropped off. This one day, I forgot my key. I had gone to her house, and she was right there opening the door with my nephew, Mateo. You know, the little kids make a little sound. She was right there opening her arms to me and asking me what's wrong. She said, I said, I forgot my key, can I stay here? And of course, she said, come in. She gave me food. She gave me time to do my homework because I was failing classes. She was there. She picked me up a few times from when I was down. She was there for me from the beginning. And I'm grateful for her. I truly am. She's the one who did my makeup and prom, which is why my best friend Melody did not recognize me because of my eyebrows, which is very pretty. Te amo. Mi tía está en ella. Mi tía. For as long as I've been alive, I've always gone to visit her to see how she is. Because she had lost her husband. And whenever I go over there, I see my uncle. And I would always cry for him. Because he was the love of your life, and he was my uncle. And I grew up with him holding me. So regardless, he was my uncle, no matter what was going on. Te amo, tía.
Bravo!
Bravo! Alo.
Come here.
Alo, during dance practice, I was so stressed. She could tell from my face. Okay, hold on.
Who's drinking? Girl.
She was there for me at practice. Where I was stressed because these girls couldn't get it right. And it was making me mad. And she took me outside and said, breathe. You'll be okay. She told me straight up what's going on in this practice, who are the girls that couldn't do it. And after that, I went up to those girls and I told them, either get it straight or leave. She told me it's gonna be okay, which I needed to hear during this entire process of looking good. And for that, I've known her for 3 years, just as I've known David. But for 3 years, she was there by my side. She was there for me in school, in classes, asked me, are you okay? She would always make sure I'm okay, even when I'm not. And for that, I love you. Kimberly. Me and her recently got closer together. But ever since, she has been such a good friend to me. She has been there for me. When I would laugh, she would even more laugh at something stupid. She would be right there when I would show her my phone. She would be like, oh my god, what is that? Oh my god. She would laugh so funny. It would make me laugh all the time. In class, I'd have a bad day. She would always ask me, are you okay? Look at this funny thing on my phone. And I would just laugh my ass off. Sorry for the cussing. But she's a good friend to me. And I'm glad I have her in my life.
and yet the feeling will tune it off.
But from that day, she always asked me, just like Aldo, are you okay? Or recently, I was crying, and she was there. No, wait, no, you were there. But in the hallway, she would ask me, wipe those tears off, your brand. Don't let this person get in the way of your happiness. And for that, wait, how do you get your hair to travel? How do you get your hair long? It's very beautiful. Okay, and for that, I love you.
Bravo.
And Daniel. Daniel, I recently met him a year ago. Me and him didn't talk at first, but he's a good friend. He was there for me today when something was going on. He told me, don't cry. He actually got a hoodie and wiped my tear off. He had made me laugh today, which is probably some reason why I'm laughing, besides my siblings being stupid, but I love them. But thanks to Daniel, I was laughing. And I'm grateful for him.
Bravo!
Now for masters.
What's your speech?
Yes, I'm
Cello!
Growing up, I felt ugly because in school I would get bullied. But my siblings would always tell me, they're dumb. They don't know what they're saying. You're beautiful. And from that day, I've always thought of myself beautiful. Or whenever I feel down, I remind myself, you are beautiful, thanks to them. But growing up, I was taught to be strong. I was taught to see the good in people. But there are times where you can't see the good because there's none in there. I'm grateful to myself because I'm brave, I'm strong, I'm beautiful.
Bravo.
Yeah. I'm hilarious even though people say I'm not. I'm a lot of things, but one of them is honest. If you want the truth, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for you. I'm a truly brave, strong, kind, honest person, even though some people don't see it that way. Certain people would say, she's mean. No, I'm strong. Like my sisters are saying right now, they're jealous. And they might as well be, because I have a good family, I have the best family, and have amazing friends. And for them, I'm grateful. But also, I'm grateful for them, because they have taught me life lessons that I had growing up.
Bravo. Bravo.
Mateo. One other thing is, I grew up having anxiety. But ever since, I've learned how to control it. I've learned how to make sure no one sees how I'm crying. It's not that I find crying being weak, it's not. Is I was taught, don't let people see you being weak for just a minute, because they'll grab you from that. They'll tear you apart.
They taught me to be strong, brave, and care about people. And if someone was getting bullied, I would always say something, like my brother said, speak up. Growing up, he would say, speak up. Don't let them drag you down. Keep your mouth. Say something with it. Ever since, whenever I would see someone get bullied or hurt by someone, I would say something. Of course, they would get mad, but I wouldn't care. I did what was right, and I don't regret that. I love myself, I love my family, and I love my friends. I love all of you, and I love myself most of all.
Aplauso para Yasmín y palabras del señor Juan Carlos Fonte.
Okay, I'm gonna pass.
Buenas noches a todos. Quisiera agradecer a todas las amistades que tienen familiares.
No se oye, mijo.
Acércate, acércate un poquito nada más.
Un poquito más el micrófono a la boca.
Les decía que quería agradecer a todas las amistades y familias presentes por haber llegado a celebrar los 15 de Yasmín. Y bueno, bendiciones. Saludos. Gracias.
Bendiciones. Ok.
Vamos a brindar.
Ok, sí, nos colocamos todos de pie, por favor, todo el mundo con su copa. Nos colocamos de pie, la copa para la quinceañera. En nombre de Bethelstein, queremos darte nuestro más caluroso sentimiento y palabras de mucha energía y mucha salud para ti, Yasmín. Ya sé por qué quieres ser abogada, ya sabes, ¿no? Cuando se gradúe va a ser una buena abogada. De muchos eventos que he podido presenciar, ha sido uno de los muy pocos donde he visto a una quinceañera que no escribe, sino que todo le sale en el instante desde el corazón. Aplauso para ti, Dios te bendiga, muchas bendiciones. Nos colocamos todos de pie, por favor, con sus copas. Todo el mundo con su copa en la mano, por favor. Ok, la copa arriba. Ok, en el nombre de Dios Todopoderoso, mucha salud, muchas bendiciones. Y Dios, como dice, Dios salve a la reina cumpleañera. Muchas bendiciones para ti. Arriba y todos decimos a la cuenta de tres. 1, 2, 3.
¡Salud!
¡Salud! Y bendiciones para todos ustedes. Pueden tomar asiento. A continuación vamos a ir llamando a mesa por mesa para la foto del recuerdo. ¿Ok?
Thank you.
Flow. Bueno, baila todo el mundo, vamos. Empieza la hora loca, vamos.
Thank you.